lights. Patrick, Kenny, Junior, Norman, Payne and Kev. My wife's got a bee jump freeze with a sex addiction, and it's hard to walk him in the park. Every other dog we see gets chased and pinned and fucked and licked in the ass. My grandson smoking weed in his bedroom, texting girls photos of his cock. Jesus, fuck. If a dad comes round, then I'll smash his car with a rock.
Big old balls, they drag me down. You find me dancing around sexy town. Red light district peddling around, and then I get mucked and my pants turn brown. Bachelor pad covered in spaff. Dorito crumbs all up in my bath. Flaking skin on my head. Sunburned flesh, let it shed.
Wake up Sunday, wife just punched me, said she's hungry, gotta go cook. Wi-Fi's broken, so I gotta watch my porn in the form of comic books. Brother, look, wank myself with a single finger, Captain Hook. Can I go smoke my pipe with a random man in a dark and weary nook?
Bought a transgender man, 2 pints. Can I get lucky and fist him tonight? Cause lick my cock with a pink hair tie. Not too tight, no, I don't wanna die. Used to have a dog, his name was Francis. Then he ran away, what a selfish bastard. Now I got a cat and his name is Patrick. PKJ got jealous of the tactic.
When I say hi, I get shut down. When I'm outside, I get stressed out. When I got people around, I'm anxious. Nobody likes me, what the fuck now? When I say hi, I get shut down. When I'm outside, I get stressed out. When I got people around, I'm anxious. Nobody likes me, what the fuck now? Call me the neighbor's name when you fuck me. You ain't gotta kiss me, you ain't gotta hug me. Shit, I mean really, just do something. Please just touch me. I don't wanna go to my nephew's birthday. His friends play rugby, they might just hurt me. Last time they just kicked my shins and spat on me Christmas turkey.
Hit another spliff and I feel alright. Then I hit another line, I convulse and fly. Rip out me heart, left open wide. Jump on the back of me ex and pipe. I'm like hello, I'm like hi. Do you wanna back rub, do you wanna die? Do you wanna catch up, do you wanna cry? Do you wanna slice of the painful pie?
Wife's got a best friend, her name's Sandy. She's got a husband, his name's Andy. I like to picture them when they fuck and imagine that her ass tastes sweet like candy. Who's got a camera? Wanna take a picture? Got a good shot of my best friend's sister. She's bent down with her hand on red rock card in the middle of a game of Twister.
I play the horns of death. A girl said hi, now I'm obsessed. Stick it in the wank bank, back to the nest. And it's candlelight, laid back and caress. I'm not alone, the voice in my head tells me I'm handsome and great in bed. When you got chocolate, who needs sex? I can just wank to a text instead.
When I say hi, I get shut down. When I'm outside, I get stressed out. When I got people around, I'm anxious. Nobody likes me, what the fuck now? When I say hi, I get shut down. When I'm outside, I get stressed out. When I got people around, I'm anxious. Nobody likes me, what the fuck now?
X-Pac bless many years.
Hello.
It's Rebjorn. It's Blue Boy.
Man, do I have a crazy bad headache, and I think it's because we listen to calls every single day to find one to play on Sunday.
Well, that kind of rhymed a bit, and you should definitely have been on the track with the band that opened for us.
I'm black tomorrow. Oh. So I've been rapping a lot recently.
That's good. That's good. It's good to have hobbies.
Yes, sir. All right. Hello, everybody.
Hello. Hello, everyone. Hello. Can you hear me?
Can you hear me? I can hear you.
I can hear you. All right. Let's get it going. Should we talk about the call before we play it or just start playing it?
This call is a call that I forgot even existed.
Yes.
We were listening to it, and it kind of surprised me, because I would say, as far as Jamie calls goes, this is like a top, what would you say? Would you say top five? It's really good.
Ooh, five is, it's good. It is good. Here's the deal. I was gonna hype this up, and we decided against it. I was even gonna downplay it at the start, but, it's
sorry,
good. No, you're good. I didn't tell you. So, I'll say for sure, top 10. For sure.
Top 10. All right.
Top 10. The background for this is, guys, so if you all remember, or you might not, if you go to Heelborn's channel, the jerk, he's got a call. It's called Yancy Fallout, I think. Is that what the name of the call is? Maybe?
I believe so.
This is the day before where Jamie first tells Lorne about the turtle dance. So should we just get into it?
Let's just get into it.
Let's get into it, man.
Hello. Hello.
Hello.
How are you?
He seems upset.
He's How already seems you? Like a little sourpuss.
A little sourpuss.
How was your hangout time with Will?
Oh, he's all pissy. That's a lighter, by the way.
What? How was your hangout time with Will?
That's my new boyfriend, George Glass.
George Glass.
It was fun.
What'd you do?
Oh, no. What could she have possibly done?
They had sex.
Oh, no.
He made up a silly song.
Oh, okay.
Oh, yeah.
Well, that's not that bad.
That's pretty nice.
Nothing to get jealous over. All right, good call. Yeah.
The end. All right, guys. We're out.
So I made up a dance up for it.
What was the song about?
Yeah, what was the song about?
It was about a turtle.
Ah, okay.
Yeah.
Oh, okay. This couldn't possibly be bad.
What's it? Why did the turtle need a name?
Yeah, why does the turtle need a name? Yertle?
Yeah, so far this is pretty innocent.
Oh, it was Yancy.
Okay. Nothing to get jealous over yet.
Yeah, nothing jealous about that. We have a donation, Blue Boy.
Okay.
Falsic Malkor tipped 3. He said, join the Falcor army. Thanks for stopping by.
Thanks for stopping by.
Thank you.
And I think it's the Falcor cartel, I believe.
Oh, sorry, it wasn't even the Falcor Mafia, it was the Malkor. I'm very confused right now.
Whatever.
All right, back to the call.
Cool.
Oh, Yancy, you make me dancey.
Yeah.
Cool.
That's cool. That is cool. Lauren's being real
reasonable. Yeah, pretty cool. Mm-hmm.
Are we sure this is a top call?
Yeah, this might not be the one I was thinking of.
Yeah.
I'm shaking my panties.
Uh-oh.
You made up a dance for that. Nice.
What?
He seems reasonably calm, you know?
Mm-hmm.
I just wanted to let you know that DSP Historical Society donated. They said, perfect timing. Was just listening to the Yancy duo last night. I voted for Black Boy.
Oh, thank you. Yep, you're not a racist.
Okay. Thank you. Thank you so much. Let's just... Lauren's probably calm.
Whatever.
Whatever.
My issue... Yeah, I completely feel fucking neglected because you give so much fucking attention to Will.
And oh, baby boy.
And royally pissing me right the fuck off.
Oh, no.
I don't want that motherfucker ever try to get his nose in the middle of our fucking arguments ever again.
What?
That fucking bullshit is pissing me off. You know that fucking picture I sent you earlier?
Uh-huh.
Why don't you scroll up and read that? That picture I sent
you. Read the picture?
Scroll up and that's how fucking important I feel to you.
What? Yeah, well, how do you read a picture?
I don't know, man.
Sent you a picture of my fucking cock.
Oh, you no!
You fucking saw it. Guess what?
Guys.
Because Will gets head up.
Go ahead.
He sent a picture of his cock and she never saw it.
So I was going to say.
That's how little Jamie means to him.
If she would have just saw it, we would have been.
She just saw it.
We would have been fine.
He would have been kosher.
Everything would have been kosher. The world would have been in a perfect balance of
But she kosher. Was so involved with Will She didn't even see what was probably the 50th picture of his dick that day.
Probably, actually. I mean, they were nonstop back then.
How, on average, back then, was he sending like 14 a day?
I would say the average was between a number of like 8 and 18.
I like to exaggerate a bit. So
no, it's good. There were days where there was 20 of them. There was 25. Like, he just really wanted to show the process.
Yeah.
Of cooming into a condom and shit. And it's like
they were all the same underneath his balls picture.
Oh yeah, there was the underneath his balls. There was like one where he would try and shoot down his urethra a lot too, which was really gross.
Oh fucking hell, dude.
Yeah, that was pretty gross.
Why?
A lot of, like, bent over in a mirror kind of thing. I don't know, whatever.
Yeah, he took that mirror around the trailer to take pictures.
But yeah, would it be, like, the top of his dick, the right side of his dick, all in the bathroom.
All angles of his dick.
Yeah, under his balls, left side of the dick, back to the top of the dick.
3:30 in the morning.
Yeah, well, no, it'd be, like, 1 for Jamie. 1 in the morning,
that's true.
Snapping photos. Hey, what do you think about this? Huh?
So this is the one time Jamie didn't comment on his penis? Is that what he's freaking out about?
Yeah, pretty much. Way to go, Jamie. Yeah. You need to comment on every single cock.
Everyone. You got to tell him how great it is.
Tell him it's the most beautiful bent cock.
It's beautiful.
All right. Gorilla Face Gwen has donated, said, can Black Boy drop the N-word? He has a West Moist Pass. I'm going to say don't do that.
Yeah, sure.
No.
Okay.
Don't. Not on this show, guys. That's a different show. Thursday Lane tipped. They said, I'm a submissive top that loves blonde chicken cream pot pie. Thank you, Thursday Lane and Gorilla Face Gwen. Thursday Lane, what about blonde hair chicken cream? Do you also do farts in your face matter? All right, let's get it going. Sorry. Let's go back a little bit and hear him talk about his cock picture.
She didn't saw it.
Yeah, she never saw it. Let's hear it.
Sent you a picture of my fucking cock. You never even fucking saw it. Guess what? Because we'll get head off your fucking ass, Jamie. I'm so goddamn tired of this shit. If you fucking want him, go fucking get him.
Now, I would like to say that I know that there's been an argument about most rage and all that stuff, and I know that people say that Will doesn't get him that mad, but he was pretty mad there.
Pretty mad at Will.
I also have a cat in the background meowing and stuff, so he was pretty mad.
His head was up her fucking ass.
I mean, he hung up. He'll probably call back and be calm, right?
Always. You know, he's gonna go clear his mind and then come back, and he's gonna approach this. Mm-hmm. You know, maturely and appropriately.
Yeah, this is going to be a conversation between two adults hashing out their issues.
About a dancing turtle song and not looking at a picture of his dick.
Right. Most importantly, ignoring a cock picture, but also there's this song about a turtle that's also an issue. And we got to solve
50 year old man.
Yes.
Yep.
All right, let's see what happens.
Hello.
What happened?
I don't know. I'm fucking pissed off. I'm tired. I'm tired of this fucking bullshit with Will. I'm tired of you doing all the fucking shit that you do, and you think it does not affect me. You think it doesn't hurt me. You think that I just don't matter.
No, that's why she doesn't want.
What I feel don't fucking matter. Will's head is right up your fucking ass. Every goddamn time you and I have a fucking fight, he marches his ass in there and asks what's going on. What's going on? What the fuck is it? None of his fucking business.
Oh my god, he's so mad.
You told him to keep his curious ass out of our fucking business.
Stop blaming Will.
Uh-oh.
You stick up for him one more time, I'm fucking finished.
Stop blaming
Will. I'm tired of your bullshit. I am tired of your fucking bullshit with him. You fucking marry him so much, why don't you fucking marry him?
Very mature.
Yeah.
Stop sticking up for him.
I like how, because she has a male friend that she likes being around, she has to marry him.
If you love him so much, why don't you marry him? And also, if Will lives in the same house and he can hear Lauren screaming, why wouldn't he walk in and say what's wrong?
Right, yeah. Like
Jamie just like frantically typing her screaming at Lauren on the
keyboard
or whatever.
Jamie's listening to the phone with speaker on, so everyone in the house can hear Lauren just going on and on about nothing every day, right?
Yeah.
Hey, Jamie, what's going on in here? God damn it! All right, I'm sure he's going to calm down.
Yeah, he's calm this time.
Strix is killing his fucking moles and I got in their business all the Maybe fucking not. Time. Mark is his ass in here. Interrupts our phone call.
Oh, no.
2 nights in a fucking row.
I wonder what those are about.
Did you pass around that Will does nothing fucking wrong?
Hmm. Well, wait a second. Now I'm on Lauren's side.
In our business.
You're on Lauren's side?
Well, 2 days in a row.
Will walked in and interrupted their conversation.
Yeah, I didn't hear that when we were listening to this, but now, you know, Will needs to get the fuck out of there, dude.
You know, I think you're right. I think Will's a piece of shit.
Piece of shit, dude. Let's get two days in a row?
Let's kick him to the curb, you know?
Will is a son.
And you got his fucking cock right in your fucking hand every goddamn time you turn around.
That's interesting.
You know how much it fucking pisses me off, and you don't give a flying fuck about how I feel about it.
What did Will do?
Interrupts our fucking phone call 2 nights in a row.
Wow.
Then he matches in last night when you and I were arguing that she's gonna fucking rescue the day. It's none of his fucking business. No, you grow the fuck up. Go fucking get him, Jamie. You can't stop your fucking bullshit when that guy has his head up your fucking ass.
Lauren, put the gun down.
Lauren, everyone can come out of this alive. Just put the gun down.
Lauren, just put the gun down, please.
Let's talk about this. Is there anyone we can call for you? Wow. You know? That was, he was mad.
And that's the whole call, right?
And that's it. And that wraps up. Lauren,
all right, guys. We'll catch you next Sunday.
Next Sunday. Should be a little longer. We have a donation.
Oh, wait, there's more.
Yeah. We had a donation from I Just Stopped By.
Okay.
Little known fact about Lauren Lynn Armstrong. He was a member of popular WCW wrestling stable, the West Texas Rednecks, and helped write the popular song Rap is Crap. I do remember that song, actually. They were feuding with the... what was that group with Conan and Rey Mysterio?
You have 15 seconds of Russell talk, and then we are going to continue the call.
Yeah. Just what was the name of the group?
Get it out of your system. I don't know.
It was the... I want to call them the Rascals, but that's not it. Anyways, that group.
Four,
I remember that song.
Three,
it was wonderful.
2, 1. We're done with wrestling. Let's
yes,
go.
Okay. That's enough of wrestling, everybody. I just stopped by. Thank you.
Thank you. I just stopped by.
Craig has a question. Is Lauren mad right now? I don't think he is. I think he's faking it.
Nah.
Yeah. Sounds like...
Sounds pretty calm to me.
It sounds pretty calm. All right. Let's. There's a little bit more.
Please. Shin, that is not true. He doesn't have a new girlfriend in her 20s. God. That is... that person has been misinformed.
You have been stopped.
I'm like the guy from Game of... The bald guy from Game of Thrones with no penis who has the little ravens everywhere. What's that guy's name?
Oh, man. What? Littlefinger? No.
I'm basically that guy. You know, I have little ravens everywhere. I know everything.
It's been a while since I watched it.
She's not real. Darn.
Anyways, yeah. All right, here we go.
Hello.
Don't you ever talk about Will like that again.
Oh,
do
no.
you hear me?
Oh, he's gone now.
All right, now that's...
And that is it,
the
guys.
End call. We're done, guys. And that's it. And that wraps up everything.
Yep.
We're never coming back. McNuggets donated. You know everything. Okay. You know. Oh my god. You know every. Oh my god. Now there's another one. Hold on, guys.
Whoa.
Now I'm getting confused. This scroll wheel is so tiny. Sorry, guys. Give me a second. You know, everyone says that you and Will sound alike, and I just don't hear it. To be honest, I don't hear it either. You know. I don't think I sound
me
like anyone but me. What was that, Blue Boy?
Nothing.
Oh, no.
Thank you, Nuggets. That was...
Thank
we
you,
appreciate
Nuggets.
It.
There's another one from Mastodon Hurricane. Don't want to interrupt the stream with wrestling nonsense out of the respect of Blue Boy, so I won't. But real quick, the LWO is my favorite stable since DDP, Bam Bam Bigelow, and Canyon formed Jersey Triad in WCW. Thank you so much. That's high praise.
You can talk about wrestling. I was messing around.
No. We've already gone through the wrestling break. There's no more.
You can keep talking about wrestling.
No. I Want a Biscuit, also donated. Lauren has been getting letters for years exposing what is going on. He dismisses them. What made the letter you mentioned he got telling him about the throuple different? Why did Lauren believe that letter as opposed to the others he has received? I think it's because two things. They sent it twice. His probation's been on his ass nonstop about getting Jamie to confirm her identity, and she wouldn't.
And this letter was sent before things were on the internet.
Well, there's that too. Just very bizarre. But yeah, I just think like after a certain amount of time of hearing that over and over again, his you know pea brain was like, yeah, something's not right here, you know.
Yeah.
Thank you so much, everyone. Platy just donated. What's the max number of hangups in a single day? That's a good question.
I think we did like a speed run where we tried to get him hang up as fast as possible.
There was that, and yeah. I'll say over under probably somewhere around 20.
Yeah.
Probably.
See, Wee Man knows I'm a mark. He knows I like Wrestle Talk.
Support Wrestle Talk. I didn't see you sound like Will. I said you do a Will Great impression. That's true, Zach. I appreciate that. Reborn sounds nothing like Will, and Blue Boy sounds nothing like Casey. This is a conspiracy. I agree, and I wish people would stop. Thank you, everyone that donated. Appreciate it so much.
Thank you.
But yeah, I don't know. I think just time is what did it on those letters. Plus, a certain lover's channel that he found.
Yeah, I mean, I don't really know why he believed it. Whatever it was about that letter, he
did
for some reason.
Yeah, he was all about it.
I don't know.
He's real secretive about that. That combined
with the well, and also because he was allowed to do video calls, and we can only keep up the tape on the camera for so long.
Yeah.
So I think the letter combined with the fact that we were not going up there.
Yeah.
Because we, you know, we aren't women.
Pee-wee has donated. I just want to say a little old school quote, shoes of peace stomping on the enemy. Jesus Christ! Thank you, Pee-wee. Never gets old to me. I don't know why Mike Servin isn't in black and white as well on the screen, but Ramona's Diapers donated. If you run short tonight, play a rerun. Thank you, Ramona's Diaper. Also, Wes has donated, and Wes has a non-wrestling-related question, okay? Do you think Shawn Michaels could replace Chris Hansen on To Catch a Predator? He doesn't talk with any of the Predators. He just gives everyone sweet chin music while his theme song blares. Yes or no?
Oh, that'd be great.
That's two thumbs up for me.
Yeah.
Thank you so much, Wes. Thank you so much, everyone else, for donating. It seems there's more to this call. Should we listen to it?
Yeah, go ahead.
Now let's push play. Well, do you have something to say, Blue Boy?
No. Jen, do you have any more pics of Lauren's diseases, like mold, bacteria, and
infection? Yeah, he sent Jamie two of his feet rotting one time. I think you used one as a thumbnail, right? There's another
one. Sorry, I don't know.
No. I'm just saying, I know there's one out there. I just think there's another one, but it's just the same kind of photo, but I don't think, I think that's the only mold he showed.
Yeah, just his feet.
And I guess if you count like him ripping the walls off and looking inside of his walls, that might count too.
Yeah.
DSP Historical Society has donated. What do you think would happen if the two of you did show up in person at his door?
Nothing.
Yeah.
Nothing. He would treat us like that guy who went there and filmed him for 6 hours. I think he'd be a pussy.
Yeah, you just chat about how everything's misconstrued and how he's a good guy, and he'd kick it up with us, right?
Yeah.
Ramona's Diaper also donated poutine or donaire, and why? Poutine, just because, you know.
What's the second one?
I don't know, but poutine's going to be my answer every time.
I'll have to Google it later.
It's, but my answer's poutine. Hold on, I'll just skip the line and do that. It's like it's a fried meat sliced sandwich in a pita rolled with tomato, nope, onion, and sweet tangy sauce from Canadian Halifax.
I don't like fried food.
Well, there you go. Poutine on both ends here, folks.
It's too greasy.
Raised by Mom has donated, what's in worse condition, Lauren's teeth or his trailer? That's a tough race. I don't know who's winning that one.
Do you think his teeth hurt?
I don't, at this point, probably not. Just due to it all being shattered, right?
I don't know.
I would assume nerve endings.
How does he close his mouth?
Sorry?
Like how your teeth line up when you close your mouth? Like, does his not do that? You know what I mean?
I just think the nerve endings are all dead from all the cigarettes and coffee or something, and he just doesn't feel anything there.
That's true.
I heard Lauren brush one time in a Ramona call.
I've never heard him brush his teeth. And in fact, I don't think I remember seeing a toothbrush when he gave us the tour.
No. He brushes with coffee grounds now.
I think Lauren is the kind of person, he only brushes his teeth when he leaves the trailer. Maybe. At most.
Maybe. He doesn't chew gum either, or like it does anything to like negate coffee ciggy breath in people's faces.
That's another thing too, because you know how when you wake up and your mouth tastes gross, so you immediately go brush your teeth? I feel like with Lauren, because he smokes a cigarette and drinks coffee, he just forgets.
I think that his mouth has just felt gross for so long that that's just the normal for him.
Yeah.
Like if his teeth were clean and his mouth were clean, he'd be like, oh, what the fuck is this?
That would be uncomfortable for him.
Yeah. And then he would start like double timing with the cigarettes.
Yeah.
Wow. Well, these are great questions, guys. Thank you.
Yeah, thank you.
Let's see what happens next.
Okay.
What?
What is your fucking issue?
You and your fucking sticking up for Will. Don't tell me you'd never talk about somebody again. That motherfucker is not gonna fucking get in the middle of our arguments. I told you before, many fucking times.
And don't tell him what to do, 87.
This is a two-way fucking relationship. There is no three people in this fucking relationship. And there's never gonna be.
Don't tell him what to do, 87.
There is never going to fucking be. Do you understand me, Jamie?
This is where we would hit her in real life.
No.
Wait, like Eddie pointed out, I thought he was done now.
No.
Look for Will like four times.
No. He's gonna keep going with this until he gets his way.
Oh, okay, so it was an empty threat?
Yes, always the empty threats. Now again, I really do feel that she would get a good little slap across the face during this one, you know?
Or at least, like, cornered.
Cornered for sure, but I just, like, right here, this part, hold on.
There is never going to fucking be. Do you understand me, Jamie?
He'd have his hand, like, cocked like he does with the dogs, or he'd be pointing right in her face, you know?
Yeah.
It's coming, though. It's brewing.
No.
I'm not marrying you and Will. That shit's not gonna fucking happen. So you might as well power it into his fucking head right now.
That way.
Oh no.
You know what the fuck I mean. So be a fucking smart ass.
PBY, I was devastated when Shawn Michaels turned his back on his lifelong friend.
I don't care if you're great friends with him or not. That doesn't bother me. When you start avoiding me and ignoring me for Will's talk,
and giving Will all this
fucking attention, and you don't give me fucking shit, you don't even notice the picture that I send you, fuck you, I'll find somebody else that does notice me.
Man, well, he really wants his cock pic to be recognized, huh?
I'm not gonna be somebody that's gonna...
And that's it. Have a good night, everybody.
And we're done, guys. We'll see you next week.
Wrap it up on 7 minutes of audio. We did good.
That was only 7 minutes, and we've been live for 30 minutes.
And this stream is
going to be very annoying to listen to later for people.
Yeah, it's all right. Hey, look, there's more.
Hello.
Maybe it's time for another break.
Oh no,
Jimmy! You want another fucking break? You go ahead and have one. All you want to do is have a break so you can have more time with fucking Will and his fucking cock.
Is that how it works, Blue Boy?
Yes.
Someone just
I don't know.
Yeah, let's take a break. I need to enjoy this cock before before I move on. What an idiot. All right.
You can't do this cock off your fucking mind.
Because you won't shut up about it.
He brings it up constantly. He does it with Rod, too. He's like, virgin pain is virgin
pain.
All
of us. Everyone in this stream right now is thinking about Will's cock.
And it's
because one won't shut the fuck up.
Yeah, sorry, I didn't mean to interrupt you. Yeah, it's the only reason people are thinking about Will's cock is because Lauren can't shut up about it. Voice to Voice has donated, keeping kayfabe, has Will ever been genuinely helpful to Lauren, only to then immediately notice Lauren slamming him in text to Jamie or Casey? I mean, Will definitely tried to help him, but Lauren never listens, so Will...
I mean... We weren't really in the business of trying to make Lauren a better person.
No, but I will say Will tried at times, and it was met with just a brick wall.
I mean, I don't want him to get better. I want him to be a piece of shit forever.
No, that's a good point, yeah. I mean, once you figure out, like, this isn't going to... Nothing's going to change. Like, this is it for life. It's like, okay, well, hey, I heard this great song about a turtle. You know?
Yeah.
Is Will a mark? Oh, absolutely.
We're all marks.
You can't get him out of your fucking relationships.
More assumptions.
More assumptions, my goddamn ass. Every fucking time you turn around, you're fucking mentioning his fucking cock.
She hasn't mentioned it once! Thank you again, Voice to Voice, by the way. How many times has Jamie brought up Will's cock tonight?
In this call, none. That's what I'm confused about.
No, I will say she does mention it a fair amount at the beginning, but...
In this call?
No. In the relationship. Oh. Sorry, in the relationship.
Oh, okay.
Is there any point in time where either of you were starting to fall for this guy and start something serious? Blue Boy, I'll let you answer first.
No, but I did fall in love with Reborn.
That's true. That's the true story, guys.
And we do stuff.
Anyways, back to the call, everybody.
You answered the fucking fiance and wants to hear shit like that?
I'm not stupid.
Oh, bullshit. Couldn't even that fucking phone text me the other night because you had Will's cock in your fucking hand.
That is a sentence I never thought I'd hear.
What do you mean I'm a scared man? I'll tell you, time after time.
You didn't have it last night, 87.
I couldn't really...
He said, sorry, I can't get over it. We couldn't have phone sex last night because you had Will's cock in your hand. What?
We gotta listen to the call before this, because I don't remember that.
I don't either. We might have to backtrack some more.
Why don't you understand what I tell you?
Time last night, 87.
Well, you fucking had it the night before that. You was gonna use it last night.
Man, a lot of Wildo going on.
All this fucking shit with Will,
you are the reason we haven't lately, because you are tired, old man River.
How the fuck do you expect to have a fucking life with me when you got that cocksucker shoved up your fucking ass?
You are the reason we haven't lately, because you are tired, old man.
Maybe the Wildo is his, like, greatest rival.
It could be. I mean, that... Okay, I'll say... You got a point there. That Wildo has made him cry more than I've heard most people make him cry.
Yeah.
The goddamn dildo. The dildo is going to be in the merch shop for sure. Check it out. Whenever that happens.
How can a Wildo be a cocksucker? That's a good question.
Well, here's a good example of that. How can questions be cocksuckers? I'm done answering your cocksucking questions, Jamie.
That's a good point.
I mean, everything can... I guess everything can, including Lauren.
You really think that I'm going to fucking have a life with fucking Will as a third wheel? I don't fucking think so.
You are the reason we haven't lately, because you are tired, old man River.
Guess what? I'm working to try to get me and you something better.
What are you doing? Me, cunt.
What are you doing? You're holding Will's cock in your fucking hand constantly. Inviting him in to fucking get in the middle of our fucking arguments.
You are the reason phone sex hasn't happened.
He walks right in the middle of our fucking argument and says, what's going on, Jimmy?
You are the reason phone sex hasn't happened.
He walks right in the middle of our conversation.
You are the reason phone sex hasn't happened.
Get the fuck out, you just fucking want to repeat yourself. You don't want to hear a fucking word I say. I'll get him.
He's doing the same thing.
He's not acknowledging anything she's saying. He's just screaming.
Face to Face is donated. What is it with Lauren always bringing up the cocks of the many catfishes love interests? We had the doctor, the therapist, Dan, Will, Rod, and so many more. Lauren seems to always have cock on the brain.
He's always thinking about cock.
He loves cock.
I think because Lauren would show his dick to anyone, he assumes all of us men just whip it out anytime we see a pretty girl.
Definitely. Like that line he said about male gynecologists walking around with hard-ons all day.
Right, because you want to see, you know, diseased vaginas up close and get a boner.
Right, yeah, definitely. That pus is hot, you know?
Yeah. The yeast infections or whatever Jamie had.
Yeah, but I think, like you said, Blue Boy, I think it's that fact that, like, he sends photos and wants nudes all the time and just would jack to it, so he thinks everyone's like that. Like, I need nudes now. I gotta touch my wiener, you know? Anyways, thank you so much, Face to Face. I love that name.
I'll join you for a thruple shin.
Because you don't want to hear what you're doing wrong. When you know fucking goddamn well what you're doing wrong.
Oh!
You know what you're fucking doing wrong. The only problem is you don't want to let go of Will.
Shut the fuck up.
No, pull his fucking head out of your ass.
Stop blaming me. You are the reason phone sex hasn't happened.
The reason phone sex hasn't happened is because I'm trying to get us something fucking better. But you can't even work with me on that.
The reason we haven't is because I'm trying to get something better?
I don't know what that means.
I don't either. I'm assuming what he's trying to say is I'm trying to get you up here for something better than phone sex, but his mush brain made it sound really dumb.
I said you fucking threatened me with Will's cock.
But you blamed me a minute ago, moron.
Well, you threatened me with Will's cock.
But you blamed me a minute ago, moron.
That's true.
Fucking spend hours upon hours with Will. That's why you can't pull Will's head out of your ass, because you feel safe with Will.
Okay. Would anyone feel safe with Lauren? I'm going to say no.
No. In Petite Dream, that's all they do, is look at diseased vaginas. Don't kid yourself.
Yeah, it's all diseased.
What are you going to do when you're here? Will's not here. You going to feel safe with me, or are you going to fucking call Will?
Probably call Will. I mean, let's be honest with ourselves.
Yeah.
Do you hear yourself when you talk? Jimmy? Just ignore the fact you get called out. Keep rambling.
Won't you ignore the fact that you get called out?
Do you hear yourself when you talk? Just ignore the fact you get called out.
You don't see the shit that you're doing. Even when I tell you, you don't see the shit that you're doing.
Right, what did I just say?
Doesn't matter, I didn't hear a fucking thing anyway, because I was trying to talk and you were talking over me, trying to talk over me.
I don't know.
Exactly, fuck off.
Oh, all I hear is how perfect Will is.
Stop blaming me. You are the reason phone sex hasn't happened.
Yeah, well, what's the reason you never even noticed the picture of my cock on your phone?
But you blamed me a minute ago, moron.
What's the reason you never even noticed the picture of my cock on your phone?
Got her, Lauren.
Hey, Blue Boy, what's the reason you didn't notice my cock on your phone?
I have get so many of them.
You're telling me! No. Dummy.
Huh. Gee, I wonder.
You heard it that time, see how you ignored it again.
Gee, I wonder.
Mm. I like how he thinks he has a point here. Like he has her cornered.
I'm fucking ignored too.
Yeah, he's gonna run over. Yeah. Guess who's in the hot seat right now? Jamie.
Yeah.
You ignore everything I fucking say. My feelings do not matter, Jamie, because Will's head is still up your ass.
How does she walk around like that?
It must be hard. She's like very tall. She probably could.
That's true. I mean, like, she could wear Will as a helmet, I guess, or something.
You think?
No, I've addressed all this shit countless times, and I'm sick of it, Lorne.
Yeah, well, no fucking kidding. You don't think I'm fucking sick of this shit? Having him to deal with a fucking third wheel in our relationship the whole fucking time we've had a relationship, Jamie. Not one day has been spent without him in it.
Time for a break.
Back to the past.
Back to the fucking past? It's in the future still.
Lorne's a changed man.
It's in the fucking present, Jamie.
Things are so different now.
Yeah, I am.
Lorne's a changed man.
Believe me, I'm saying the same
fucking
thing.
Things are so different now.
I'm saying the same fucking thing. Things are so different now. Will is still right there.
Shins has donated. Excuse me. He said, love you guys. Shins, thank you so much.
Shin, come join our thruple.
You can join. We'll make a thruple. Sorry. I had some popcorn. It's not sitting right.
Head's still here.
I'm different.
He would be different, Jamie, but you just can't pull Will's head out of your ass. He's so perfect.
Let me just change my password back.
Fuck about you already fucking did that. You can't get away from him. It's your favorite fucking word as well. Either Will or Will's big, beautiful cock.
That's not a word.
You don't think about how much...
What'd you say?
Will's big, beautiful cock is not a word.
I mean... I guess there's a lot of hyphens in it or something. I mean, the way Lorne writes, it could be, I guess. But yeah, you're right. It's not one. You're right.
You stop and think about how much of a relationship we're going to have with your mind not being on Will's cock. You think about how I feel every time you fucking mention
and
that bullshit.
And now I get to wear the PJs I want to wear, not the ones Lorne wants.
Do whatever the fuck you want. Do whatever the fuck you want, Jamie. You're doing it anyway. You're killing us because you can't pull Will's head out of your fucking ass.
Man.
And you can't get his cock out of your hand.
What a combo.
And this is from fucking day one.
It's been happening since day one.
Yes. Yeah. Not day two. Day one. Okay, let's say, Blue Boy, you're dating someone, and there's an issue from day one, and you're on, what would this be? Month, like, six of the day one problem. Are you sticking around, or are you going to scream on the phone and tell them to be with you?
Yeah, what does he want her to do? I mean, it's been 6 months of this fight, and she's not giving up the will, though.
Yeah, I don't know. This is what he wants. You're right, Lorne. I'm gonna cut this Wildo up and throw it in the garbage, and Will can go sleep in the streets, because I just want you.
But that hasn't happened for 6 months.
Right, but this time...
Bitching about it.
This time, things will be different. I don't know. I think he just thinks he can convince her. At some point, she's gonna cave. But...
Maybe take a different approach.
Maybe. But he thinks that if he just keeps running his head into the wall, eventually it will break down, you know?
Yeah.
How long do you really think we're going to last in a marriage without you being able to fucking call Will?
Now I can actually do work and make money instead of worrying about hurting a man-child's feelings.
Damn!
Yeah, yeah. Yeah.
Can't wait to have my life back.
Yeah, well, obviously not.
What?
But nothing changed.
You're so stuck on Will's fucking cock anyway. You're so stuck on Will's cock, you never even fucking see mine.
But nothing changed.
You're so stuck on Will's cock, you never see mine. You heard what I said. Obviously nothing's changed, Jimmy. That is still up your ass.
Now I can actually do work and make money instead of worrying about hurting a man-child's feelings.
Yeah.
But nothing changed.
You obviously... You obviously weren't fucking worried
but
about
nothing
it.
Nothing changed.
You still got Rose cock in your
but
hand.
Nothing changed.
All right, Jamie, let up the clutch.
You threw all your other toys away because of fucking Will's cock.
Good one, Lauren.
Isn't that fucking just beautiful?
Is that the word you would describe with?
No. It's a weird choice, but...
Well, beautiful. I was waiting for, like, cunning or intelligent.
Yeah.
Beautiful.
You think your fucking fiance is supposed to be overjoyed by that.
I see your dick 10 times a day. How many times do I have to see it, moron?
You hold Will's cock every fucking day.
Got him. She's done.
You're not complaining about that. Thanks a lot, though, Jamie. I really appreciate that.
Goodbye, Ramona.
And we're done.
Does Lauren drink enough water? No, he never drinks water.
Well, his coffee's basically water.
You know, sort of. I'll give you that. Well, that was good. What'd you guys think? Top 10 for sure, right? I mean, the
what's
only
the
way...
latest on Glenn's?
Sorry, go ahead.
Sorry.
No, go ahead.
I was reading comments out loud.
You're good.
Do you have an update on Glenn's health?
I do not.
As far as I know, she's still kicking it.
She's still kicking it. Let's just... there's a little bit more here.
Oh, there's more?
What?
Cawd runs away, doesn't want to hear what saying, what's new.
Cawd, there you go again. Using Will's word, coward.
It's Will's word? I thought it was just an English word.
Unfucking believable.
Going to hang up because you can't face the truth.
What? The truth that you enjoy holding Will's fucking cock, but you can't stand seeing my cock 10 times a day? Hey, what's that tell you? You must be in love with Will.
Point,
that's what it means.
That's it. Done.
But
doesn't mean you must
changed.
Be in love with Will.
I can hear you, dinosaur. Can you hear me?
You must be in love with Will.
You know, the way you're talking about dinosaur, it sounds like you're in love with him. Why don't you just go get him?
You want a dinosaur or you want a tornado?
I wish a tornado picked me up.
Right, you know what, Lorne?
You must be, Jamie. You can't pull his head out of your fucking ass.
You don't want to listen.
Don't want to listen to what? How you want to fucking hold his cock all the fucking time? Shove it up your fucking pussy?
I heard someone in Cornville saw Lauren holding hands with a woman. Apparently it did not look like a catfish.
No, it's... No, he was not... That's not...
Set the record straight, Blue Blue. Let's hear it.
Listen. This person is not his girlfriend. It is a woman who... said she was going to do this to troll the community, and it looks like it's working because everyone's talking about it.
That sounds about right, you know.
But he does not have a girlfriend. Okay, this, come on, this is Lauren here.
Come on, guys.
A woman that is described as in her 20s, like that right there,
should be in,
is
a
enough.
Huge
yeah, it should
red
be
flag.
Enough. Yeah.
A woman in her 20s, huge red flag.
Yeah, don't believe that. Whoever said that is... I mean, I'm not going to say anything. But, no, she is not his girlfriend. He doesn't have a girlfriend. He's never had a girlfriend.
Never has.
Where would
never
he meet a girl? Like, just where would he meet one?
There, over the phone in his Catfish Anonymous or whatever the hell it is. His one-on-one counseling now that he's out of class.
He's not really out of class. I mean, he's just... He's, you know, solo class.
Alright, well, let's get back into this real quick.
See, do you think I want to fucking listen to that shit?
So I'm done. Good luck, bye.
Oh, whatever.
And that's it.
That's it.
That's it, guys. Damn, we're not even halfway through. Let's go.
Hello.
Hello, Lyric.
Hello.
I love
Shane,
you.
I wouldn't lie to you. She's not his
I'm
girlfriend.
I'm so fucking tired of him getting in that relationship.
That's not good.
Can you imagine? I love you. Fuck off.
That's what I want to hear.
Right.
there's no way that I can tell you how much it bothers me.
We are done.
We're not fucking done. Don't give me that fucking horse shit.
Whoa.
Lauren decides.
You're not even paying attention to how much I'm being bothered by something. And it involves the guy that is right there with you. There's no way that I can tell you how much it bothers me.
Security's not him.
Jamie, you are using a goddamn cast of his fucking cock.
Why does he always say it like that?
Should we hear that one more time?
I hate the way he says cock.
The frustration in his cock.
Jamie, you are using a goddamn cast of his fucking cock.
I don't know why he says
that. How do you expect me not to fucking be bothered by that?
All right, now, guys, you're probably asking yourselves, well, Reborn and Blue Boy really hyped this call up. I mean, he was screaming at the start, which is, of course, fantastic, but what could make a call better than just yelling, Lauren? Blue Boy, do you have an answer?
For me, it'd be crying.
Well, ladies and gentlemen, you're in luck.
But you don't fucking care to see my cock because you see it 10 times a day, but you're using a statue of his.
A statue?
Yeah.
How do you expect me to be able to fucking deal with that? When he's living right there with you.
You've been dealing with it for 6 months, bro.
Right, like, at this point, you need to either, like, pull the cord or deal with it. You know what I mean? Like,
yeah.
God damn. I just couldn't imagine, like, just berating someone for this long, hoping that something's going to change.
You are neither of those things. We are done.
Oh.
Oh, well. It's over.
Oh.
He's mad.
And now it's over, right?
And now we're done. Hold on, what's this?
Hello.
Real quick, though, before we continue. Oh, sad, Lauren. Grunt126 says, as always, thank you both on a controversial topic tonight. Any crazy WrestleMania predictions? Thank you, Grunt.
WrestleMania predictions. A crazy one?
I mean, it's all, my opinion is going to be predictable, but.
It seems pretty predictable. I'm going to get crazy, though. I'm going to say Roman Reigns wins.
Ooh, that is kind of crazy.
Is that crazy?
I say so, because it's really pushing for, like, Cody to beat him. Yeah, that's a good one.
But we're marks. We don't watch that shit. We don't watch that garbage. Wrestling.
I don't know why people even bring up wrestling on this channel. Platty. Sorry, go ahead.
Nothing.
My bad. Platty donated, said, may I ask where Trailers for Sale comes from? It's a song he sang. That's about it. Can I rewind for that juicy rage? Yeah, of course. Hold on.
Go fucking marry him then!
Go fucking marry him then. Hello.
Hello.
This means Lorne.
That's one of my favorites. Is like somber Lorne.
Pouty. Hello. Pouty,
yeah.
Lorne.
Now he's going to get real serious.
We have a donation from Irma Blue Mom. They said, Blue Boy, it's me, your mom. I told your pappy about Monegros and he disowned you. He said he didn't fight the Viet Cong so you could hang around hoodlums.
My parents
are
dead.
Just a little bit more.
That's not my mom.
Oh.
It's not my mom.
Well, it says it's your mom. There's more from your mom here. You are out of the will unless you scream the N-word, which I don't suggest you do. Love, Mom. P.S. I sent you and Reborn cookies.
Aw, thanks.
You said that wasn't your mom?
Oh, no. Irma?
Oh, my God. Irma. This is a prank? Prank call. Prank call. Hang up on them. Facet Dreamer just donated. Isn't day one when Lauren said that Jamie's future husband would resist her loose mud hole? What a gentleman he is. Thanks for another great Sunday service, Rebjorn and Blue Boy. It's a stream I wait all week for. Thank you.
Thanks.
Thank you, everyone. Ramona's Diaper donated again. Reborn, let Blue Boy take over Sundays with Cawd, and you go help Heelborn get some calls uploaded. Love, Mom. Thanks, Ramon's Diaper.
I don't want to do this by myself.
Well, it's your show now, man. I got.
We're renaming it.
No. It's got to stay the same.
Sunday Blues.
Sunday Blues are good, though. I do like that name. Thank you, everyone. Okay. You want to hear what happened next?
With Lauren? I do.
Okay.
I think we should end this.
Oh, fuck.
Of course you do. You got Will's talking, you fucking end. You got Will right there. You know, how much better can you get, Jamie?
That's a good question.
You wanted Will in our relationship the whole fucking time.
Lauren, please don't be mad.
Don't be mad. How the fuck do you not expect me to be fucking mad?
Oh, I'm sorry. It said that your dad fought for the Viet Cong, not against them. I apologize, misread.
How the fuck do you not expect me to be fucking mad when that motherfucker is shoved right up your goddamn ass every minute of the goddamn day since we've been together, Jamie?
Man, he's mad.
You know how fucking pathetic that is.
This whole thing is pathetic.
I fucking love you and you bring that motherfucker that far into our relationship? Are you kidding me? For him to be there as a friend, I can understand.
Okay.
But you bring it deeper than that.
Being there as a friend would be coming in to console her when she's arguing with her boyfriend.
You would think.
And Will does that and Lauren gets pissed.
Yeah, Lauren's under this...
So what's a friend?
I'm sorry, please wake up.
What's a friend then?
No, he's not a friend. He's getting in their business, Blue Boy. He needs to be able to isolate her one-on-one and have no one interfere. No one can know what he does.
Right. You're right, I'm wrong.
I think we're all wrong.
You cast this fucking talk! And you use it!
You cast this
talk. How do you not expect me to be fucking hurting because of that?
Oh, here we go.
I love you and I want to fucking marry you, but that motherfucker is not going to be in our relationship.
I don't know.
He's not going to march in when we have an argument and try to fucking rescue Jamie's day when it's not his fucking relationship. It's ours.
Someone shut that dog up.
I can't fucking believe that we're going through this shit again. Why can't you get him?
Hold on.
Play that again. Go through this again.
This right here has got to be the most pathetic thing.
I can't fucking believe that we're going through this shit again.
Why can't you believe it, Lauren? This has been your life since you got out of prison. Is going through situations like this.
This has been his entire existence. Probably even before the sting with Amanda James and shit.
Probably.
She's like, listen,
I can't believe we're going through this again.
I appreciate the Dale Earnhardt merch you got me, but there's this guy. What? Should we hear that one more time?
Yes, that was just... Man.
Yahoo.
Can you imagine?
He is it. I can't. I mean... I can't. When is the last time you've been so frustrated you've cried and yelled at the same time?
Over my girlfriend having a cast of her ex-boyfriend's cock. It's never happened.
Yeah, that's weird. Yeah. This just sounds like everyday stuff the way he's talking about it. Alright, here we go.
I can't fucking believe that we're going through this shit again!
He's like 50 years old.
50, crying over a dildo.
Oh man, he's like his old.
What the fuck?
Nothing. I just love that part.
Oh, it's so good. Why are we going through this again, Blue Boy? Bulletproof Lori just donated. Just donating to let you guys know that I'm not going to donate tonight. Thank you, Blue.
Thank you.
Blue Bay really appreciates it when people acknowledge not to donate.
Yes.
People keep donating. We keep going through this shit again!
Why can't you get him away from you like that? I understand you feel safe around him. He's a nice guy. But you're blending in way too fucking far.
What? Jamie's really crying here.
I want to be with him for the rest of my life. I don't want him there.
Okay.
If he wants to be there as a friend, I'm fine for that. But he's not going to be in your life that fucking much. No. What are you fucking kidding me, Jamie? You wanted me and you to take a fucking break, and he's there with you 24/7.
I would say a break would be healthy in the situation.
What are you doing to us?
It seems like the most mature thing being said in this conversation.
Why are you doing this to us?
You get a break again and a break again.
I think we should take a break.
I think that's a good move.
You think we should take a break? Then me and you take a break, and you wind up with fucking Will, and you wind up marrying him.
What?
Because that's how.
Well, then it works out perfectly for Jamie.
Yeah, Jamie wins in that scenario.
Yeah, I'll say, okay.
And you think we should take a fucking break? Because he's been in our relationship every fucking day since day goddamn one.
Wouldn't it be weird if she said yes, like, oh, Lauren, you're a genius, I'm going to do that now, and then she does,
yeah.
And he's fought, like, he's just sitting there crying because she moved on and did everything he told him, told her he was going to do, or whatever the hell, I can't figure out what I'm trying to say. The people got mixed up there. Wes said he went on a break with his girlfriend so he could bang Will. It's a common thing.
Yeah.
Girlface Gwen just donated and said, I wish Blue Boy would stick to his roots and stick with Black Boy. Wes told me he shot Tupac.
I'm only allowed to be black on Mondays.
Yeah. Guys, come on. This is serious business here, okay? He's blue today. He's black tomorrow.
Damn blue.
Right?
That is right.
Boom.
How can you love me like that?
You don't love me.
No, I love you. You're not fucking loving me. You're loving Will.
I think Jamie might be laughing.
You're spending every fucking day with him. You got to use his fucking dead cat and his cock in your fucking hand all the time. That's not loving me. It's fucking loving him.
Oh, my God. How is it loving him? Again.
I want you to want me so fucking bad, Jamie. I want it to be me and you.
Jamie, go to him.
I'm going. Jamie, come on, it's your future. Let's hear this one.
Go to him, Jamie.
I want you to want me so fucking bad, Jamie. I want it to be me and you. How is it ever going to be me and you if you can't let go of him?
Booblay, how's it going to be just me and you when you can't get rid of Wes?
Can't believe we're going through this again!
I love the fucking days that we've had this week where we've been so fucking calm and got along so fucking well and nothing to fucking worry about.
Didn't he just complain in the past 2 days?
Listen. She's been... Yeah, I was just going to say that. The past two days, this has been going on.
Yeah, well, what has she been doing the past 2 days, Blue Boy?
Apparently holding Will's cock in her hand.
What? She doesn't have two of them, does she? Maybe not yet. I don't know when that came in the timeline, but...
But then this mother... He fucking marches in when we have an argument like he fucking has the right to get in the middle of our argument. He's naturally curious. Yeah.
Lorne, don't be mad.
Curiosity killed the cat.
Lorne, don't be mad.
He just really shoehorned that phrase in there. Why did he say that?
I don't know, because Will always says that he's curious, I guess, so he needed to make sure that the cat was killed from it or something.
Gotcha. Shin has a question for me. He says, how does someone who hates Lorne so much put up with this? I put up with this because I hate Lorne. I like it when he cries, and I like to hear him yell.
Yeah, this is all payoff right here. This is pay dirt.
Yeah. But like I said at the beginning of this stream, I have a headache constantly because of this man.
Yeah, no, I agree.
It ruins the quality of your life if you like trolling him. It's actually not as fun as you might think it is.
No, headaches is a common thing, for sure. I remember, having to take many naps.
I think people assume that when you're trolling Lorne, you got to do it for 8 hours a day like Ramona would do it, but it's really not like that. I ignored him all day long and then would call him for like an hour a day.
Yeah, if that. I know some days were even shorter. The robot at one point had to literally say, like, okay, you can only call me at this point. And then he would get, like, maybe an hour to 40 minutes. 40 minutes to an hour. And then she had to go work. And that would be it for the day. And even that is just taxing.
I remember when I first started, we started trolling him together. And when you showed me all the texts that he sent in a day.
Oh, yeah, yeah.
That shit blew me away.
Yeah, yeah.
Because think about how much Lorne texts, and it is not, you're not even close. It is constant.
Yeah. Yeah, I remember it's like, oh, we're going to do something. Well, here's what he sent this morning. And it's just like from 1 a.m., his time, until you wake up and he's just talking to himself. I'm getting up.
All day he talks to himself.
I'm driving. I'm going to Walmart. I got back from Walmart. I'm going to Mom's. I'm going to Mom's now. I'm almost home from Mom's.
Baby, here's a picture of a tree in the road. Like, okay.
Here's my windshield.
Bro, I know what a tree is.
Did you know what a deer looks like before Lorne showed you?
Fucking hell. Well, I do now.
Well,
I get his pictures of deer and snow.
Yeah.
He forgets Casey's from New Jersey. She knows what trees are.
Right, yeah. Never seen a tree before, right? You never seen...
Like, oh, you don't have trees in L.A., huh?
state of Maine trees, though.
Yeah.
The
headache is coming back just thinking about it.
I know, I hear it. At least he only got trees. Like, before he was restricted on nudes, it was, you would wake up and it's 15 dick pictures, and then...
But at least the dick pics are funny.
Kind of. They get old.
I mean, they're funny.
They get old.
Especially when they're the same ones every day.
I mean, back me up on this. There are times where you think he's just resending the same photos, and he's not.
We did do a compare and contrast where we were convinced he was sending the same six photos every day. Because they looked very similar.
Nope. No, they weren't.
No, they were different. Examined them. We took a magnifying glass of those things.
But yeah, then it's just like kissy selfies all day long. High angle kiss shots. Go ahead.
I'm like unfazed by his naked body now.
Oh yeah, it's nothing now, but...
It means nothing to me. Like, it's not even... His lumpy body is just... it doesn't shock me at all.
No. And you know what I think is, if he were dating an actual woman, which he's not, but if he were, and he were sending those dick photos all the time, same thing would happen. She'd just become, like, desensitized to it. And like Jamie said, it's like, well, I don't give a shit about him.
A real woman would not put up with this for more than a few days. Which is another reason why, guys, he does not have a girlfriend. Because despite what Lorne says, he is not a better person in person.
Yeah.
Oh, no.
Love donated.
Pictures.
Sorry, go ahead.
No, I was reading the comments in the chat, but if they want me to answer, they'll donate. I'm shitting. what was I saying? The pictures where he is...
His asshole.
The asshole ones, but I think the ones that I really can't look at are the ejaculating ones.
Yeah, there's a fair amount of those, too. He loves showing...
Those ones make me physically ill.
Yeah, it's disgusting. Love donated and said, why is Jamie risking losing a pedo?
That's a good question.
That is a good question. Thank you for the donating. I don't know.
Not even like even if he wasn't a pedo, he's not a handsome dude.
No, he's not.
He's an old man with fucked up teeth. He smokes. He lives in that gross trailer. So you can even remove the pedophile part from it. Why would Jamie would never put up with this?
No. Anyone that looked like Jamie would never even humor Lauren's phone call, let alone.
Oh, and I want to congratulate the real Jamie, the woman behind Jamie, on giving birth to a beautiful baby.
Congratulations.
With her beautiful husband. This man is not like Lorne. I ain't even gay, but this guy's really, really good looking.
I think he's Rod. In my mind, he's just Rod.
We actually did use him for Rod.
Raw. Raw.
I don't know the name or the gender of the baby because all of her posts are in Russian and I cannot read Russian.
There you go.
But congratulations nonetheless.
Congratulations, everyone. Round of applause.
Round of applause for real Jamie giving birth to a healthy baby.
Can I add to that congratulations by saying, let's everyone round of applause. Lauren still doesn't have a child and probably never will. Let's round of applause. Round of applause.
I don't think you need to say probably.
Well, you know, just in case.
I mean, Preparette might give him a baby. Who knows?
Reborn Apology Official just donated. They said, hey, everyone, this is a rare, serious video from me. I'm going to read what I wrote because that's the best way to organize my thoughts. Please bear with me. I apologize to all the people in the TCAV community, especially Westmos. I'm sorry, really sorry. Thank you, myself, I guess.
I feel like I've heard that before.
Yeah, it's something, you know.
From two separate people. Did you ever send pics to Lauren? If so, were they stick photos? Lauren got pictures, but they were kind of like the ones that... He didn't get, like, I mean, I didn't want to send him any, like, real sexy pictures of Casey. I don't want that shit on his phone. But they were the ones where, like, you know, there's a dude in the photo or... Oh, stock photos? Well, no.
No, they were Casey.
No, they were all... They were Casey.
Winnie Syllables donated and said, Was Lauren ever reprimanded by probation because of sexual activity on his phone or laptop? I mean, it's a fucking joke. He was not allowed to send nudes anymore at one point. That's about it.
Yeah, but the sexy talk, remember that?
Oh yeah,
I think I've mentioned it a bunch of times. I don't know if I want to mention it again.
Just wait
till we get there.
One more time.
Jamie and Casey were texting some gross, really gross things. I wanted to see how far, like, we could go, kind of. Like, with saying gross shit, like, Lauren, I want to lick your asshole, like, in way worse things than that, and see if he would still be down for it, and he would talk really disgusting. And probation had to tell him to stop sending R-rated messages, because she didn't want to see those anymore.
Yeah. That's when you got a in the chat.
I remember being like, no, this is during the thruffle. Do you remember when it happened? It was like 3 days straight. It's all he wanted to talk about was like how you buttholes babies and shit like that. Do you remember that?
Something like that. Yeah.
I don't know how you don't remember this.
Oh, Preach, what's your question? I'll answer. Oh, okay. I apologize. All right. Sorry. I thought I just feel left out. Nothing.
Now. You what?
You what? Listen, Blue Boy, I don't know why we're going through this again.
I don't know what's happening.
I don't either. Thank you, everyone that donated. I think go ahead.
Yeah, I'm not really good at explaining stuff, but...
Me either.
Where was I going with this? The text messages that were all discussing. What was the question? I don't even remember the question.
The question was he ever reprimanded for, like, sexual activity on his phone or laptops?
No.
Honestly, no. With the exception of, like, not being able to send nudes because they told him he needs to stop that shit. And, I mean, he was sending nudes from outside of his house. Outside of his trailer, right?
Yeah.
So, and nothing happened. So.
Yeah. So, there's a long-winded answer to your very simple question.
There you go.
There you go.
Let's listen to Lauren. Some more. He's got something to say. You're right, count of three.
We're not taking a break.
This is awkward. Hey, Lauren, it's Will. Oh, no. I don't know how I paused it. Like that, but... All right, well, should we let Will talk for a little bit?
Yeah, Mike's got a question, though.
Yeah, go for it.
How did Casey tell him she didn't like his singing? I think I just told him he's not good.
Yeah, I was like, none of that. You can stop.
I was just like, please don't leave me voicemails like that. You're not good at this.
All right, let's see what Will has to say. I'm sure he's going to ruin the mood.
Well, Will.
I just want to see how you guys were doing.
Well, me and Jamie are having a discussion, Will, right now.
Are you crying?
Yes, I am.
What's going on with you two?
It's between me and Jamie.
Well, I want to help you two. I care about you both.
Ew.
Well, thank you, but this is stuff that has to be between me and Jamie.
I know. Well, I sort of, like, listened a little bit. I'm sorry for that. I just want to help you two out. You know, you're good kids. Reborn back in. Yeah, Blue Boy, we're probably going to have to go to Wrestler's Court because the kayfabe is just not up to par here.
What did I do?
I don't know. That's all I'm just saying. Hey, okay. Lawrence Will. There's my impression of Will saying, hey, Lawrence Will. That doesn't sound anything like him. Dr. Cunt has donated. Would Lauren's great wrestling name be the Underage Taker?
That's a good one.
I always imagine, like, Tony being the Undertaker. I don't know why.
Oh, because he's dead?
A little bit. But even so, like, Lawrence's own little world, he wouldn't be Taker. He'd be more of a...
Lawrence Eugene.
Yeah, Lawrence Eugene. That's a good one.
Do you remember when Aunt Sharon was hot?
I remember when Mom was hot. I don't remember that.
Oh, I admit to being Casey. I tried saying I wasn't for a while, but I think people figured it out very quickly.
Blue Eye doesn't like doing works. He's all shoot. You know what I'm saying?
I was thinking George and Animal Steel as well.
Yeah, hairy, weird.
Yeah.
I was going to say like Festus.
Or Snitsky. Is that his name?
Yeah, what was Luke Gallows' gimmick where he was like...
was Festus.
That was Festus where they ring the bell and he'd become like a killer?
Yeah, and then the bell stopped ringing. He went back to being like a... dummy?
A stupid guy? Well...
It's contemporary.
Something like that. Yeah. I think we all know where this is going with Lauren.
Anywho.
What seems to be the issue?
Well, you're not going to get in the middle of my and Jamie's discussion.
Well, Timmy, it's okay. It's not.
This is between this is with me and Jamie.
Jamie, stop crying. See, now, how could Will be the one doing crying when Will just talked while she was crying? That's crazy. Right, Blue Boy?
Right.
Kayfabe's alive. Why can't we just have a dialogue here?
Because it's not your business, Will. It's mine and Jamie's business. We're trying to get through this together.
Right. No, I understand that. But, like, you know, I'm going to be your best man. You're my friend. I'm Jamie's best friend. Why can't I help you to, you know, maybe help open up areas that you can communicate?
Because me and Jamie can get through this with each other.
Well, I mean, no offense, Lauren, but you guys argue a lot. Down my plunk.
And we can get through it with each other. We always had before.
Yeah, but haven't you had like 3 or 4 breaks? Blue Boy, I have a question for you. Do you think they're going to make it through it on their own?
I mean, these two really love each other, so probably.
I think it's going to be...
They have a special connection.
Yeah, I think it's going to last a lifetime. Many lifetimes.
Yeah.
Like that, you know.
This is the last time Will's ever in a call.
Yeah, this is... Will might even die after this call. Who knows?
Mm-hmm.
Not having any more breaks.
Well, I just heard Jamie say that you guys were going on a break.
That's between me and Jamie.
Mm. Right, Jamie?
Dan Jones says, mm-hmm. How can you cry to another man about your girlfriend? He not only is he crying to another man, he's crying about to the man who his girlfriend uses a statue of his cock.
Yeah, I mean, it's probably the worst case scenario for him.
Yeah, damn.
You know? Preach, there were many shoots. Many shoots. Yeah, I couldn't imagine, like, if you're so upset about this one guy, you wouldn't sit there and cry to him about, you know, there's like a call a few days after this where he's, I think it's out, where he's crying about the statue to Will. The goddamn dildo, Will! And you're like, man, this is not the guy to be talking to about this. Donation from Love. Did the real Casey reach out to you?
Yeah, she said it was cool that I used her name and likeness to troll her. She said she's cool with it.
And then you high-fived each other?
Yeah.
Hell yeah, dude, that's awesome.
No, it really, though, she's suing me.
Oh, yeah. That too. Okay. That's a weird combination. She was okay, and now she's suing you.
Yeah.
Thank you so much, love.
This is not going to be... Will, I don't want you prying yourself into what me and Jamie are talking about right now. This is between me and Jamie. Because it is not your business. It's mine and Jamie's business. This is mine and Jamie's relationship.
But
this is part of the problem.
Why?
Because you're always prying yourself into our arguments.
I'm not, though.
But you are. You just did it the other night.
Yeah, but like, when was the last time I did it before that?
Before that, you hadn't done it for a while.
Well, then how am I doing it all the time?
And me and Jamie got through it without you prying yourself in.
Right, but how am I doing it all the time then?
Well, you just started doing it again the other night.
Yeah, but you said I'm doing it all the time.
You used to do it all the time before that. Then you stopped. And me and Jamie got through whatever arguments we had, we got through it without you.
Well, I don't understand. You're saying I'm doing it all the time, and I did it one time.
You did.
Well, it's two times if you can loop right now.
You stopped doing it for a while, and you showed us a lot of respect by doing that, because you showed me and Jamie that we can get through this together without anybody else being involved.
Right, but then you just started doing it again the other night.
But then you just started doing it again the other night.
Yeah, but Lauren, that's not healthy.
That's even worse.
Lauren, do you know, it sounds like you're trying to isolate her.
I'm not trying to isolate her. I'm trying to get me and her to be able to talk and get through things together.
Right, but you guys talk for hours. Again, I'm in the other room. I can hear the robot every night, and you guys just say the same shit over and over again for hours and hours and hours. And it's either one of the two of you is stubborn, or the both of you are, you know?
Can't believe we're going through this again.
Again!
Well, this is between me and Jamie, and we want to get through it together.
Jamie, is this true?
Oh.
She's shaking her head now, Lauren.
No, no.
Now what? Now what do you got?
Oh, no.
That's what I thought.
Well, guys.
I hope you muted yourself for that.
I did. Yeah. I muted on their end, not your end. You have to hear it.
Woo.
Yeah, Tiffany, Will's just trying to bring people together. He's such a good gay, you know?
I'm saying this is helping Lorne out, really.
Yeah.
Kind of.
It's like giving him trying to open his eyes to the problems they're having, and so yeah, that was pretty good. Hold on, there's another little bit here.
Oh, there's more?
Yeah. Did you want to... Oh, hold on. Okay, we got two donations here.
Okay.
I don't know that name. Sorry, I can't read your name. As God is my witness, he is broken in half. By God! He's broken in half. Thank you so much. Also, Reborn's Apology Official 2 said, the person who was alerting people to my behavior in a video was not a troll, but was someone trying to blow the whistle on me, which was the right thing to do and should be applauded. Sorry, Drink Celsius. Wow, this is good. This is drugs in a can. Thank you so much, me, for doing that. I appreciate it. What do you think about Celsius there, Blue Boy?
I've never had it. And I don't think I ever will.
Yeah. What about JR saying "Bacchanal"?
Bacchanal.
It's a great one. I always love JR going, that man's got a family.
Yeah, that's a good one too.
Thanks so much, everybody. Well, there's a little bit more here. Should we listen to it, Blue Boy?
Yes, sir.
All right.
Hello.
Hi. We need to be able to get through this stuff with each other, Jamie.
Yeah, Will needs to stop getting involved. That's true.
Yeah.
He's helpful and smart. You should listen to him.
Jamie.
Oh, no.
When we have an argument, when we're married, and we're alone together, we are not going to call Will for help.
Ooh, that's scary.
That's a little frightening.
You and I can talk things out. We've been doing it.
We should take a break, and I think we should now too.
I would love to go to Forbidden Door.
Where's it at this year?
I'm not sure. I think,
Did you drop in?
I think it's in Canada?
Of course. You know, because Will thinks that you should, it's gonna be fucking law. I'm not living like that.
Oh, okay.
You better make up your mind right now if you want to marry me or not.
Oh, wait, no, never mind. It's an ultimatum. It's another...
Lauren, these never go in your favor.
I don't want to say this is an empty threat, but would you say it's an empty threat?
I mean, he's not going to go anywhere. He already said, in the first sentence he said in this call was that he was going to stop talking to her. If she defended Will one more time, in this call she's defended Will at least 25 times.
Damn. Well, maybe this time things will be different.
Okay, let's see.
Because this is fucking horse shit.
Hmm.
This, I have never seen such fucking horse shit in my fucking life.
When did I say I didn't?
Everything Will tells you, you're taking it as fucking law.
What?
I'm tired of it. He's not gonna be in our relationship anymore.
Will wrote his own constitution and said, you know, Will is law. I'm the law.
The Lauer.
Yancy is a fake character. I don't think he's a real turtle.
I love you more than I've ever loved anybody, Jamie.
Wow.
Saw me.
I actually believe that, to be honest with you.
Spare me.
Don't give me that.
He never said
bullshit.
That to Casey.
That's true. But didn't he say that Casey is a threat to any girl that he dates? Because he's been in
Casey
for a long time.
Yeah, he said you were a threat even before I knew you. Which is weird.
It's a very disturbing thing to say to somebody.
I am not living with fucking Will in my life every fucking
you
day.
You threaten to leave every time your feelings get hurt.
I am not living with Will in my life every fucking day.
Blue Boy, would you live in your life with Will every day?
I wish I could.
I can't believe we're going through this shit again.
That's not the way our marriage is going to fucking work.
I've never had someone say they love me and talk to me the way you do.
Really?
Damn.
I've never had somebody tell me that they love me and they want to marry me, yet they turn around and use the cast of their fucking
didn't.
Friend.
You didn't.
Well... Lorne, in Jamie's defense,
uh-huh.
That doesn't happen very often to anybody.
I think that scenario has only played out one time in human history, and it was this.
Yeah. Yeah.
Could you imagine just everywhere around the States, people are just yelling in their house, like, you got a cast of his fucking
You know when your girlfriend makes a cast of her ex-boyfriend's penis? Women.
What's the deal with the ex statue? Lauren's got imagination.
They use the cast of the French cock and cock will fucking
didn't.
Use it.
Will didn't.
Jamie, I'm not being Maggie Jo and I'm not being Will.
Damn.
But yeah,
okay.
Does it every other day.
Jimmy, you realize you're right there 24/7 with two of your exes. One of them, you're using the cast of his fucking cock.
Who gives a shit?
I do. But you don't care. Because it doesn't matter how Lauren feels about that shit. Lauren should just suck it up and
you
go along
have
with
an issue,
it.
Lauren.
Suck up the Wildo?
Yeah. Jamie, what have my issues always revolved around? Well, ever since we've started...
Continue, Lauren. Comment, E-Rock.
It sounded like he had more to say.
I think he's lighting up a ciggy. I think he had to open a new pack.
Hmm.
I could be wrong. Speculation, of course.
I always have to change my life for you and you can't do whatever the fuck you want.
You change your life for me.
Now he's inhaling a cigarette as fast as he can.
As far as I can see, you're still down there with Will.
I can have whoever I want in my life. You aren't going to control me.
Damn.
You can have whoever you want in your life, but I can tell you right now, it was not gonna be in it every fucking day. I'm not living like that.
I don't even know
what
that means.
There's no way in hell that I'm living like that.
Listen, you're not gonna have your friend in your life every fucking day, okay?
I'm not living like yet.
Not living like yet.
Oh, I haven't changed for you, dipshit. Should I go down the list again?
Oh, no. Not the
go
list.
Go ahead, go down the list.
Oh, no.
Oh,
but guess what, Jamie? At the end of the fucking list, you still got Will right there.
Okay, so he's saying that if she were to change 100 things, because Will's still there, nothing else matters. Nothing else
I
wanna matters.
I want to be with you, but only if you change everything about you.
Listen, if I have a problem, you need to change it immediately. And I will think about stop smoking so that you can breathe at my house.
Thanks a lot, Jamie. Think I have a cigarette.
Think I have a cigarette. You gotta be fucking joking me.
And the way he leans back in that chair.
Oh, man. He's such a badass.
He has never looked cooler to me.
I know. He takes that long cigarette out.
Yep. Like I said before, he's like Don Draper in a pitch meeting.
And then he just throws that pack on the desk like Kobe. Just swish. Nothing else matters.
Right there with you 24/7. Crying into our fucking arguments.
Don't imagine that so everything else doesn't matter because you have a new issue.
Crying into our life, our arguments. And it makes it even worse that you're using a cast of his thoughts.
Ignore what I say one more time.
It don't matter if I fucking ignore it or not. You
don't
ignore
imagine
everything
that,
I
so
say.
Everything else doesn't matter because you have a new issue.
I didn't ignore what you said. I heard what you said.
He said he was ignoring her, but she just addressed what he said. Kind of weird.
You brought the new issue in.
You ignored it, moron.
You brought the new issue in because you can't get his fucking cock out of your hand.
You always have an issue, Lorne.
Yeah, go fucking figure. This issue started in a fucking hospital. Do you remember that? That big, beautiful cock.
What I wear, what oh I say, God. What I do for work.
Now you got that cock in your hand all the time.
What my pie password is.
This is not a conversation I would ever have with someone.
No.
What I wear to bed.
That's different.
Yeah, Mike Scott, the backwards hat was a Casey idea.
That's a great idea. He looked really youthful.
He thought it looked cool. Yeah. I tried to get him to grow his hair out too, but yeah, that one did not work.
I think Jamie asked him to do the same thing.
Yeah.
Jamie also asked
I did get him to do the mustache.
Yeah. Wait, Casey got him a mustache too?
Maybe you did it.
No, no, I'm just asking. I don't. It's all a blur at this point. You know, it's all bleeds together.
Well, I'm gonna say I did it now.
I know you mentioned, or sorry, Casey mentioned Roy having a mustache. I do remember that. I remember Jamie pushing for a beard, but Lauren wouldn't do it because it'd make him look old, and he hates being old.
Because he has gray hair. But I wanted Lauren to have, like, the, what do you call it? Like, when your hair, like, curls on the sides? I don't know what I'm talking about.
Like, feather it?
Yeah.
You didn't want him to you didn't want him to rock like someone said, the Hulk Hogan cul-de-sac hot dog wearing hair kind of thing.
Oh, I don't know.
I think he would look like
Wisps. Is that what it's called? I can't think of what it's called.
Maybe. I don't know the word. I don't have to worry about hair anymore. So.
Aww.
It keeps happening again. Egbert donated and said, God bless you, Reborn and Blue Boy. No, God bless you,
thank
Egbert.
Thank you. God bless you.
Thank you. Yeah, maybe a comb over. Is that what you're thinking of? Like, it grows one side out?
Well, yeah, the top. Sure.
That's not what you were thinking of, was it?
Let's just go with that one.
Oh, no.
So we can move on.
All right, moving on.
You know what I mean? Wow.
Wow. There's some silence. Let's just skip over that.
How can you
what did she say?
How much that bothers me.
Hold on.
What she made said, him go, wow?
She said.
You know what I mean? This all from the stuff that you fucking...
How I talk to fans.
Wow.
I don't remember that argument, but I'm sure we'll hear it at some point.
Me neither. $100? No.
How can you not see how much that bothers me?
Just that Alabama hat? Ugh.
I love you more than I've ever loved anybody.
I believe that.
Well, is right, ignore everything else, guess what I'm done. I'm doing what I want now and your feelings be damned.
Uh-oh.
Don't like my friends, take a fucking walk.
Oh no. That's not good.
Never said I didn't like your friends. I don't like them prying into our fucking relationship.
I think everyone needs to start showing respect to Blue Boy. Show respect for him.
Who's disrespecting me?
I don't know. Someone, I just saw someone say, show Blue Boy some respect.
My feelings don't matter. You've made that clear time and time and time and time and time again.
Your feelings matter. The problem is you put your friends in on everything we go through, Jamie.
Oh, no.
Everything.
So I don't care about yours now. Enjoy how it feels.
Oh, no.
How do you expect us to be married when we can't fucking talk about something without you fucking telling your friends everything?
Sounds like they're going through this again.
And they think they have a right to know everything about our relationship.
Ugh, neither Mike Scott.
How can't you see that you're trying to pull me away from my friends and make everything about you?
I am not trying to pull you away from your friends. I'm trying to get you to get your friends out
exactly
of our relationship.
Exactly what you are doing.
They want to be friends, that's fine. They don't need to get
it's
in the middle
exactly
of our
what
relationship.
You are doing.
No,
it's exactly what you are doing.
Hey, done repeating yourself?
A new tactic.
Exactly what you're doing is putting them in the middle of our relationship. And I don't know how you don't think that it's going to bother me that you have a cast of Will's cock.
It's gone from a cast to a statue to a cast.
You are apt to be the most important person in my life, but I will always be more important than you, me.
Jamie, you're supposed to be number one. You're supposed to be number one to you, and you're supposed to be number one to me.
I thought mom's the number one.
You first.
Listen, Blue Boy, I don't know if he knows, but moms are golden, okay?
Moms are gold.
Oh, that's gold? Sorry, I thought it was golden.
It might be golden, I don't know.
No, you're probably right. It's moms are gold.
Same thing.
I just wanted to let you know that there's some rules that we have to follow, and that is that, one, you and I have to put each other first, okay? And if we're not first, we're not there, then we have to put our moms first.
Moms first. But in Jamie's case, it's Will and MJ.
That's right. I'll put Will and MJ first, I guess. I mean, whatever. Amy said, you're doing it again!
You're doing it again!
I'm tired of putting you first.
Next to you is supposed to be me.
It's
never met you.
Not Will, not Maggie Joe.
I'm tired of putting you first. It's never good enough.
Jesus Christ.
Jesus Christ is right.
Has Lauren finally accepted that he's not going to win this argument?
Listen, you just start.
What do you think? What is your guess?
I bet he's never going to mention the Will, though.
Yeah, it's not going to be
after
brought up
this,
in the next day of this call. And I guarantee you that this turtle song that was created today will never be brought up again.
Never. No.
Notice how you don't listen. You just start rambling your horse shit.
My horse shit is not supposed to matter because it has to deal with your friend.
Oh my god. What a pouty little baby.
I am not trying to pull you away from your friends.
Seems like it.
You don't address what I say or my feelings. It's all about you, and what you want, and what you feel.
and try to keep your friends out of our relationship. You're trying to fucking bring them in.
Ignored it again.
I didn't ignore it yet.
What's new?
I've already fucking told you. You're supposed to put you first, but I'm supposed to be after you. Not Will, not Maggie Jo.
Ugh.
But you're putting them before me.
I thought that they were supposed to be before, like, her mom position.
No, I'm not.
I can't remember.
It's so confusing.
No, I'm not.
Yeah, you are, Jamie.
Jamie.
Don't ever talk that way about my friend, about Will. Will's more respectful than you are. You're not respectful at all. He's a lot nicer.
And okay, I've got to enjoy how time. That actually looks. I'll call you when I feel leak it. You'll see what after gotta, my friends looks like.
Leak it?
And I've got a cast in my head.
What?
I'm not even play the gimmick on that one.
Why'd you hang up?
I'm busy.
Doing what?
Playing with Bill's cock.
Putting my friends first.
I don't guess nothing changes. All right, fine.
Nothing changes. Well, guys, that is the call, legitimately.
That's it. That is officially it.
That is officially it. I know we interrupted a shit ton, so... Hope you enjoyed it, though. It was a wild ride.
Well, I had fun.
I had fun. I'm glad you came on again, Blue Boy. I'm glad you had fun. I always worry that I'm going to bore the shit out of you on this show.
No, I'm good.
Yes, Dan Jones. After that call, the next call in succession is Yancy. And then Yancy Aftermath. This was the day before. It was, what, August 10th, 2020? Something like that?
Something like that.
I am not Stalker Patty. Hi, I'm here. Well, I don't have anything else for the good folks. Heelborn will have that video up at some point. I apologize. He was supposed to have it out this week. He failed everybody. What's new?
My homie Black Boy will be on tomorrow with Westmost, the Lorne Identity, and Sloth Cat. We will be listening to an unreleased Casey call that I just happened to find.
Awesome. Everyone be there. Please attend.
So be there or be square. I'm allowed to say the N-word. No one get mad at me.
Oh, no. That's a slippery slope. It's a very heelish move by Heelborn. I will be there. Be there. I can't wait to hear it, even though, you know, I have.
Sloth Cat said, be there or you're a racist. Okay.
Yeah, see, guys, come on. You got to be there. Can't wait. Should be good. Anything else you have for the people?
No, once we're done streaming it, it's a long call, so I don't know if we'll listen to the whole thing tomorrow or if Wes wants to do it over several streams. I don't know if I'm allowed to be on Mo African Americans, like, consecutively, since I am white, but...
That's what I should have said in the donut.
Yeah, then after we're done streaming that call, I'll put the whole thing on my channel.
Awesome. Cool. That's all I got. Heelborn will eventually figure it out and get some calls up. The next one for sure is the Reunited call. I know that last week call is going to take a bit just due to texts and stuff. We still need to sort that. And then this call will probably be behind that one. I also need to get Heelborn to put up the... third party smack talk, which is what happens after the ventilator calls. Jamie's got a vent. Way behind. What an asshole. But more importantly, Blue Boy, do you want to play some Fortnite?
Yes, sir. Let's go play Fortnite.
All right. Let me. Oh, shit. You know what? I closed the program. I should have been looking for my outro this whole time. Tell the people, the good people, anything.
Oh, that's. Don't do that to me. I don't like being put in the spot.
Do we have an idea of what we're playing next week, Blue Boy?
No, we'll probably be listening to calls throughout the week, and we will pick out a good one.
We will try. I mean, this one was a surprise for sure.
We'll do our best. Like, yeah, we didn't even know this one existed.
It was recommended to us from a good friend. They said, hey, what happened the day before Yancy?
What's gunshy mean? Am I allowed to say that? Is that racist?
I'm afraid to read half
the things. I hope I didn't just say a slur.
Yeah, I, you know, I probably shouldn't say half the things donated to me, but that's where we're at now. So, anyways, everyone have a great week. Thank you so much for spending your Sunday with me and the wonderful Blue Boy.
Thank you.
We'll see you next week. Stay safe. Yep.
And I'll see some of you tomorrow for the Most Worst stream. It's on his channel, The Most Worst.
I can't believe we're going through this again.
It'll be 9 p.m. my time. So whatever time that is for you guys.
Okay, bye.
Yeah. Bye.
I don't know all the words of the song on it, but I like the chorus. Again, oh yeah. You're the love that rescues me when the cold winds rain. And you're so amazing, that's just how you are. And I can't turn back now, cause you brought me too far. I need you like water, like breath, like wind. I need you like mercy from heaven's gate. There's a freedom in your arms, and it carries me through. I need you. Oh, I need you. I need you like water, like breath, like wind. I need you like mercy from heaven. There's a freedom in your eyes. Yeah, it's so funny. I need you. I need you. I need you. Oh. All right, my throat hurts. I love you. Bye.